Okay. Today, I want to take you along with me to test this Xbox that I got at a Goodwill outlet store. They call it In the Bins. This was $5. All the larger electronics are all $5. And this thing only had the electrical cord on it and the console itself, so it didn't have a video cord. So let me tell you something about Xboxes if you see them with only the electrical cord. What will happen is, you turn it on, it'll flash orange and green. And, a guy saw me testing this, and it says, you know, before I bought it, he says, I just wanted to let you know that when the light turns on and it turns on red like that, that means there's a problem that it's overheating. No, that is not overheating. That's actually because there's no video card attached. So the next thing I did was I pressed the eject button so there's no ejection. See that? Nothing. So that tells me it needs a new little band on the disk drive, and I can fix that, and I'll show you how I fix it. Anyway, let me turn this off. And luckily, I have an AV cable. Well, I'll just plug it in. I don't have to take my word in it for it that I'm plugging it in. Alright. And I have a controller that I'm going to use. Alright. And I have a game around here somewhere. Let me see if I can find it. Okay, found it. Star Wars Jedi Academy. Alright. So I got it plugged in. I got the AV cable on. Got my TV on. So, start it up. Cool. So it starts up. So we know it's not dead. And when you first plug it in, it's always going to give you this clock. Alright. Let's plug it into the different ports. Okay, so they all work. Wait a minute. Okay. Alright. Now you're saying, well, you couldn't get the drive open. How are you going to test a game? Well, simple. I'll press the button. Give it a little love tap. There we go. Now, let's see. Come on, baby, work. Ooh. Okay, so it's reading. So it looks like all we need to do is fix this again. Okay. Let me get set up. Okay, I've ejected the disc after beating the heck out of the top of it, and I'm going to take these screws off. There's six screws. There's one underneath here, and you can peel this up. Here, You can just peel it up a little bit and leave it on. And there's one here, right here. Got to break that. Peel that up. There is one right here. There's one here. And there's one here. So there's like six total screws. And you got to use the Torx set. And if I remember correctly, it's T10. Now, the reason why I got excited kind of when I got this was that it's had a 2005 manufacturing date, so it's really one of the most new consoles you're going to be able to find. So, anyway, I'm going to take those screws off and show you the insides. This is the little pad peeled back, and I was actually wrong. It is a T20, Torx 20. So peel these back like here from the outer edge. You got four of them. Then you got a screw here, screw there. Okay, so I've taken the wrapper off of that and cut it out with my little knife here, just to make it a little bit neater. It's a little bit neater, but anyway. Okay, so I'm about to take the top off. Some Torx screws there. There. And I think that's it, but I think it's a little bit smaller one. Let's try the T10. Let's see if it's the T10. To do this on camera. Yeah, it's a T10, so you'll need a Torx T10 and a T20. Anyway, I'm going to take this drive out. You also need to unplug the power cable and the IDE cable. One thing to note is that you'll have to take this hard drive out first before you take this the disk drive out, but once you get that screw out, you're good to go. You have the screw here, here, and here. That's three screws. It may not be the same for all models though, but anyway, I just want to tell you that. Okay, so you can just take this little plastic harness out, and it just comes right off, and then you have four regular Phillips screwdriver heads. Alright, once you've got the four screwdrivers, screws out, you can just take this apart. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it with one hand though. I don't know. Let's see. There we go. That's one part of it. But I need to get this top off. Okay, so I'm going to have to do this on camera. Alright, well, while I've got this thing open, I'm going to go ahead and clean this laser lens. And what I use is I use Windex. And a little cotton swab. so gently. Then turn it around and dry it off. Okay, you've got to get access to right behind here. And if you pull on this, it won't come out. So what you need to do is there's a little opening here. Just take a Phillips head screwdriver. And there's a little gear here. And you just work it. Keep turning it, turning that gear. And eventually, it'll come out. So this is the band that it gets worn. You just simply take that out. And what I use is this rubber bands, sleek rubber bands. You actually get these in the hair department. They're a little bitty, and that's what I use. Okay, so after a little bit of struggling, you know, just fit the rubber band right there. And another note, if you pull it all the way out, you're not going to be able to get to it. Also, it's best to put your hand underneath here so you can get a better angle in putting that rubber band around. If you want to, you can take this out, but not really worth the trouble. So I'm gonna put it back together and see if it works. A word of caution here. Now you've got to take this hard drive out or lay to the side while you're putting this back in. Do not touch the power supply. That has some stored up power in it and it will give you a shock. Okay, so I put it back together. Now is the moment of truth. It works! Look at that. And the laser still works after cleaning. Alright. I hope you enjoyed this. And I hope this helps you if you have this problem of a tray in your Xbox not ejecting.